Let us understand about subconscious mind. Subconscious mind occupies 90% of your total mind, with some variations here and there. So 90 could be 92, and conscious mind could be 8, or it could be just 88% and 12% conscious mind. Overall, average 10% is the occupation of the space by conscious mind, and 90% space is occupied by the subconscious mind. How powerful is subconscious mind? You remember I just now said that conscious mind can process 4,000 message units per minute. Subconscious mind is very powerful, very powerful. Subconscious mind is 6,000 times more powerful than conscious mind. Can you imagine the power? Conscious mind processes 4,000 message units in a minute, and subconscious mind is 6,000 times more powerful than the conscious mind. And we say that Einstein was using only 10%. Where do we stand? When will we learn to use? Today, when you are doing this exercise, when you learn about this, you will start using your subconscious more. You can actually make use of subconscious mind very properly, because the rule about subconscious is what is impressed is expressed. In the sense that you tell particular things to your subconscious mind again and again and again. How do you do that? By way of affirmations. You tell that I am confident. If you use this word, I am confident, very consciously, and you tell it again and again to yourself, your mind starts perceiving that yes, I am confident. Then actually you will turn out to be confident. What you think, you become, is what Buddha said. What you think, you become. How does that happen? How does the statement by Buddha hold good? You think is what you happen, because whatever is impressed upon your subconscious mind is what is expressed by the subconscious mind in the reality. Have you seen some people, I have seen at least, have you seen some people where the people are following some kind of teacher, some kind of guru and some kind of master, and they are so much like him, completely following that person in every way? Then in that case, the person actually starts becoming like the master. The face, the sitting style, walking style, talking style, everything actually starts becoming like him. So what is impressed upon that subconscious mind is what is expressed by the subconscious mind. Subconscious mind can make or mar life decisions. It contains blueprint of life. We have lots of cells, millions and billions of cells in our body. Every cell contains a DNA. And it is said that DNA contains our life plan or blueprint of the life plan. Since the time of conception till the time of death, whatever is our entire life plan, entire life script is there in the DNA. So the mind, being within and without, is aware of the entire life script. So it contains a blueprint of our life. So what we read on the carton boxes sometimes, handle with care, that is what we have to do with subconscious mind. We have to be really careful about this subconscious mind applications and understand it very properly. It has ability to self-heal the bodily diseases. Mental diseases, psychological diseases is fine, but even the bodily diseases are possible to be healed by the subconscious mind. As a professional hypnotherapist, I have been practicing therapies. As a professional therapeutic counselor and mind study expert, I have been meeting people, and I have come across many people with bodily diseases who come to me, and we have found that when we go to the root cause of that disease in the mind, by putting the person into the hypnotic trance, regressing him age-wise, or actually putting him into the past life regression, we find the true cause because of which the current disease is, and when we correct that, the current disease gets healed. So bodily diseases, psychological diseases are quite healable when you apply a proper strategy of understanding and healing the subconscious levels.